Here is a scene in the bathroom on the ground floor. Recently, this paint peeling appeared and it has been getting worse over time. I did not realize that the paint peeling was induced by water until one day I saw water dripping from the ceiling and the floor was full of water. At that time, the toilet in the bathroom upstairs was running constantly. The location of the toilet upstairs is right about the location for the paint peeling. So the paint peeling was actually induced by the leaking water from the toilet upstairs. The most likely reason for the water leaking is due to the toilet flange and the wax ring. I hope that's the case here. Otherwise, there might be some problem with the part below the toilet flange, which would be much harder to fix. In order to move the toilet and check the flange and the wax ring, first, turn off the water supply to the toilet by closing this well. Flush the toilet to drain the water from the tank and the bowl. Remove the remaining water from the tank and the bowl. Disconnect the water supply line. Place the bucket beneath this connector as some water will come out from the water supply line when it's disconnected. Now, I'm fastening the toilet bowls on both sides. Actually, the bowls are not doing their job right now. On one side, the bowl is too short and there is no washer to help secure the toilet on the floor. On the other side of the toilet, there is a washer for the bolt, but the washer is not positioned properly. The caps for these two bolts are also missing. I will use new bolts, nuts, washers, and caps when installing the toilet back in place. There is no caulk around the base of the toilet. If there is caulk here, I will need to use a utility knife to cut through the caulk. Actually, it's better to use caulk here to make the toilet more stable on the floor. I will put a silicone caulk around the toilet base once the water leaking issue is fixed. Now, lift up the toilet until it's free from the bolts and set it aside. This is my first time to see the flange of this toilet. I noticed that the flange is actually lower than the level of the finished floor. Usually the flange should be about 1/4 inches above the finished floor so that one wet string can be used to form a good seal. For this toilet, however, the distance between the flange and toilet bottom is too large for one wet string. It looks like two wet strings have been stacked together to solve this height issue. The lower wet string is sitting on the flange and it has an attached plastic palm extension. The upper wet string has no palm extension. We can see that the lower wet string is really dirty and its color has changed. There are some broken wet string pieces that most likely belong to the upper wet string. It looks like the water leaking occurred between the two wet strings. I don't know when these two wet strings were installed, but apparently the seal between two wet strings is not good right now. Remove the wet string from the flange. This wet string has an attached plastic palm extension. Remove the two bolts from the flange. I will actually use new bolts later. Clean the flange and the surrounding area. Currently, the flange is about 3/4 inches below the finished floor. Personally, I think instead of using two wet strings, raising the level of the toilet flange to the right height might be a better solution. Remove the 6 screws from the flange. Put the new bolts on the flange. I would like to use flange extenders to raise the height of the flange. First, use one flange extender to figure out its right orientation. The two bowls need to have the same distance from the wall behind the toilet. The six holes on the extender are not aligned with the six holes on the original flange, so mark the position of six new holes. Remove the extender from the original flange. Drill new holes and mark the positions on the original flange. In order to raise the flange height to around 1/4 inch above the finished floor, I use 4 flange extenders. Each of the extender has a thickness of 1/4 inch, and they can be stacked together. Their lateral dimensions should also match the original flange. Silicone is used to seal the gap between the flange and the first extender, as well as the gaps between neighboring extenders. put the washers and nuts on the bolts. Use 6 new screws to fix the extenders onto the original flange and the subfloor. Tighten the 6 screws and the nuts of the 2 bolts. We can see some silicone is squeezed out of the gaps. Remove extra silicone and clean the top surface of the new flange. Leave it for 12 hours for the silicone to cure. Clean the bottom of the toilet. Put a new wax ring onto the new flange. Move the toilet above the flange. Align the 2 bolts on the flange with the 2 holes on the toilet. Lower the toilet straight down until the toilet bottom touches the floor. Now the wax ring is compressed to form a seal. Put the cap base, plastic washer, metal washer, and nut onto the bolt. Tighten the nut, but do not over-tighten. Otherwise, the toilet will crack as the material for the toilet is porcelain. As the new bolt is too long for the bolt cap, the bolt needs to be cut to the proper length. Make sure the bolt is tightened and then put the cap on the bolt. Do the same thing for the other side. Connect the water supply tube to the tank. Turn on the water supply. Flush the toilet and make sure there is no water leaking at the base of the toilet. Clean the surrounding area of the toilet base. Cock the gap between the toilet base and the floor. The instability of the toilet can break the seal between the wax ring and the toilet. The cock can improve the stability of the toilet. Cock the three sides of the toilet base and do not cock the backside. In case there is water leaking in future, it can potentially be noticed from the backside. Thanks for watching this video and good luck with your project.